Welcome back, this is Eric. A Wi-Fi connection is often essential when creating applications. Usually for Wi-Fi connection, the name and password of the access point are put into the code and used. This is very cumbersome, so I wanted to be able to connect a network dynamically using a GUI interface. This base project to be introduced today used LVGL8 to facilitate Wi-Fi settings. It's made similar to the way it's normally used in Windows and Mac OS. You can see the setting icon in the upper right corner. Tap it and you see a switch to turn on Wi-Fi on and off. I'll turn on the switch to search for available Wi-Fi nearby. The list of connected Wi-Fi is updated periodically. Now let me connect my access point. I'm putting the wrong password. It must be an uppercase C. The smaller the screen, the more difficult it is to type on the screen keyboard with your fingers. If you have a lot of input in your application, I recommend using a large display. A pop-up appears and says that it's connecting. After a while, you will see a pop-up again indicating that the connection was not established because I entered an incorrect password on purpose. Okay, this time I enter a correct password and try to connect again. Change the first letter to uppercase C and click the connect button again. Try to connect again. This time the Wi-Fi connection was established. If Wi-Fi is connected successfully and this network is connected to the internet, you can get the current local time as shown in the top left corner. The layout is divided into two parts. There is a status bar at the top and a body section that can contain your content is created below it. After connecting to Wi-Fi, you can draw what you want in this body section. What if I do a hardware reset? Normally we need to set up Wi-Fi again. I need to search for Wi-Fi and re-enter the password to connect. But in a normal PC, it will automatically connect because it has a previously connected Wi-Fi credential. I have made it similar to such a function. When the Wi-Fi connection is successful, the SSID and password are stored in the EEPROM and automatically connected with this credential when rebooted. You can see that the connection is reconnected and the local time is obtained. Also, if you look at the settings, you can see that the Wi-Fi is automatically turned on. This works as you might think. I guess you can control Wi-Fi very easily with this. The source code link can be found in the video description below. As you know, the first thing you need to do is to check your display is working properly using the graphics driver. I'm using LovyanGFX because it's faster in my environment. If you want to use TFT API, you can use it of course. Please refer to the first video in this series to set up your display first. The project was worked on at a resolution of 480 by 320. If your display's resolution is larger or smaller than this, you'll need to resize and reposition all widgets. The second thing you need to do is LVGL configuration. The basic settings for this part were also completed through the previous videos. In this project, the default font size is monster 16, so you only need to change this. If your graphics driver, touch settings, and LVGL settings are done, this code will run without any problems. I recommend you check the necessary things first before running this code. Also, I explained in detail in one of my previous videos about searching and connecting Wi-Fi with the task unit from FreeRTOS. Please refer to this video, ESP32 Dynamic WIFI Configuration GUI using LVGL 7 for more details on this part. You can easily change to dark mode in LVGL config. Because the basic widget is used and the color of the widget is not specified, there is no need to change the color separately even if it's changed to dark mode. If a color is added to the widget, the color must also be changed according to the theme. This basic system is very convenient. Even if you go to another place, you can connect Wi-Fi without modifying the code. Now what we need to do is add the necessary applications based on this project. In the next project, I will show you an application that works based on this. If you have any questions, please comment below. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you in the next project.